morning to you all. A lot of energy here on the stage I saw. That's what happens when youth comes in. Youth brings in a lot of bold new thoughts, breaks barriers, also breaks hierarchies. And when I say that word, that breaking hierarchy, that's what you're doing today here. You're talking about blockchain in a way. You're trying to attempt. You're trying to visualize. How can blockchain break barriers? How can, for instance, when you read about cryptocurrencies, you read about bitcoins and all these things, you start wondering, where do I fit in technology? Whenever we have discussions, there are two things. One is that there is an immense possibility about what can be, and whether you are boarding the ship at the right time. The second is that there is a lot of fear. The fear is, what if you don't board the bus? Because if you miss the bus, your obsolescence rate is very high. I remember spanning the technology since, say, 80s. And if there are quite a bit of millennials who are working here, some of them would be born in 90s, I think, but quite a few are born in 80s. Programming was done in COBOL, and most of the stuff was being done from mainframe. The computers were the size of the rooms. You came to DOS, you started your database on Foxtro, simple DBF files. Then you said, let's make my small little LAN. And then the thing was that every computer became an intelligent one. You made a LAN, and then you said, no, this doesn't make sense. Let's make dumb terminals. Let the server be smart. And you said, let's do client server. Then you said, all right, client server is true. So when you were building those network protocols, you said, what next? You said, oh, now we have the bandwidth with us. So let's be distributed globally. We don't care where our server sits. We can have it connected with the bandwidth of the internet. And wherever our server sits, let's connect it through cloud. And when you had this situation, you came in with distributed computing. And now that when you have the era of distributed computing, what are the things that you are looking at? What are the perspectives you are looking at? Now, this is a very dynamic talk I'm giving you. I'm not prepared anything. It's something that comes. This is my bread and butter because I'm CEO of Smart City as well. So first and foremost thing that comes to your minds is, and there are quite a few programmers here. How many of you are programmers? Quite a few. So you guys are having a kick daily, because the moment your program starts working, it's like having a strong cup of coffee. You get a kick. Human beings love creating. That's what God did. When you start reading the Bible, start reading any holy text, He said He created. I remember when we used to learn C, we used to say that this is God's own language, because you could create anything. And that's the kind of kick programmers have, coders have. You want to create. Fascinating feeling. In C, you had a concept of pointers, and you had a concept of linked lists, on which the entire DBF and your one block connected to other block. And you escalate that model where this one block having a reference to another block, which gets decoded and then gets connected, is your blockchain. Almost started this thought in the 90s, and there is this whole doubt as to who is the proponent of this technology, there are two names going on. We still don't know who the real one is. Because of security reasons, the real guy doesn't come in. For us, that's not important. What is important? What's the future? As I said, two things. Either you ride the wave, or you have the fear of missing it. And that's why we are here. You want to ride the wave. Maybe I can help you a little bit with whatever little experience I have in government as to how government looks at it. And while I'm doing these government projects, as to how, to a certain extent, you'll find a market in the private sector. I believe, per se, that blockchain would take away intermediaries. So whenever you take out intermediaries, your cost of transaction goes down. Foremost would happen in the banking systems. Throughout the world, banks have been used so that the trust factor, I have to give money to A to B, the bank comes in, I'll handle the transaction. I have certain costs and I'll make money out of it. Blockchain creates that possibility of removing the intermediary. Maybe you are all aware about peer-to-peer banking. And if peer-to-peer banking has to be successful, it has to embrace blockchain. What is your second most critical innovation? I don't know how many of you have been abroad. Can I get a show of hands? Say maybe America or Australia, two countries in particular, because I'm talking about a certain system there that I'll be. All right, great. In India, one of the most difficult transactions that you have, and you are young, you want to build your houses, is buying land. Is getting for sure and knowing for sure whether this title is right. If I were to tell you that there is a 1 acre of land out here available in Ahmedabad, SG Highway, what's your typical modus operandi? What's your MO? You find a good lawyer. You tell him to take the title certificate. You do all kind of inquiries, right from the till the British times when we came in. Since 1951, our land records, you find out the title is neat and clean. There are no encumbrances. And then, once you are convinced, you end up buying the land. Now, one mistake and your life's earnings in your land writing is a big issue. Rent, one mistake in your savings can go for a toss. Second, your turnaround time to buy that land is very high. You have an opportunity. So why don't you have a case where land is almost like a DMAT account? Your land title is stored as in a DMAT form in a repository or a deposit. Just imagine what it would unlock in the real estate market. So we have throughout the world, we call it the torrent system. So there are two systems working in the world. One is in America, one is in Australia, to a certain extent UK, where the state guarantees you the land title. In India, we don't guarantee you the land title. We say, this is it. The name is here on 712, all your land title certificate, but we don't guarantee that this is the right name. Anybody can go to court and challenge this. Internationally, sturdy economies and sturdy countries have developed an insurance model where if there is a problem with titling, the insurance guy takes the hit to a certain extent. But the transition is as easy. It's like swapping your share certificate. Now just imagine our scenario if we have the land titling certificates on blockchain. Every block of ownership of land and then the transfer thereof is perfect, and there can be no fraud. And the kind of value you can unlock in land transactions for real estate, and weed away brokers who's got malefic intentions is immense. But that's the technology you have to work with the government. I say because we were working with them, trying to break it. And in fact, there was a provision in the Act in 2012. If you do a little bit of research, 2012 NRLMP Act, which has made provisions that in future, as your survey gets strong, you would want to move towards that system. That's the ultimate goal. You want to buy a flat? You want to buy a home? You want to buy a bungalow? A click of a button, and you should be sure that this title is true, this title is proper. Now imagine you buy a setup today, and your child wants to inherit it. You don't want a glitch there. Your life's earning is at stake. So this is where you would come in. So broadly, insofar as I'm concerned, I see finance. Now there's all kind of finance. So finance, taxes, for instance, your banking, and then your land writing. I recall that there are 20 odd presentations that will make use cases as to how blockchain can be implemented into different scenarios. From the smart city and the I would be definitely interested as to what are these innovations. That's one. Second is, I also extend an offer that out of this 20, whichever that I feel that we can work together, we can take this technology further, implement it in government, we can start a pilot. I'll give you the field. I'll give you the playing field. So maybe the first three or the first four. So I don't go according to the awards, because our perspective will be different as to what we'll share with our administration. So we will give you that opportunity that you can do pilot with us at one single go. Please understand, we collect 2,000 crores in taxes every year through our civic centers. Tanmayji is here from the TCS. He's aware we have just finished implementing the TCS software, which is an ERP through which we are doing all this. Smart city projects are ongoing, so I'll not talk a lot about that. Someday, some other day, some other time, we can elaborate and discuss that. This is most of your internal company matter. But all I can say is, how do we leverage innovation? What is the fertilizer for innovation? So the fertilizer for innovation is that when you do it in closed rooms, you require a field to do your innovation. We are willing to give you that. And if you are willing to take up that offer, and if it works, we transform it into an RFP, and you have a broad-based technology in one of the best cities of the country. So I wish you all the best. It's amazing to see youngsters embracing future technologies. And I only wish that when it's about Bangalore, when we're talking about Gurugram, talking about Hyderabad, we're talking about Pune, Ahmedabad now should catch up. Thank you.